Right, guys, welcome. I'm going to be doing my HDP. First things first, find out what sides the little push pins come out. I will be replacing the master cylinder on this HDP. I use the back of this because it's a lot softer. You don't need to put a lot of force into it. Just using the back of a screwdriver works quite well. But you got to make sure that they come out on the right side, because one side has got keyways, or grooves. Just pull them out quickly. So as you can see, one side has got grooves and the other side doesn't. So generally when you're putting them back in, try and put them back in so that you would have to push them out from the right hand side of the gun, because that seems to be the default side. Let me just finish these ones. Don't want to push them with such a sharp screwdriver and stab yourself in the hand. Let's just tap them all out. There's one tiny one here in the front. Try not to miss this one. As you can see, it's right there. And then the gun all just comes apart. Okay, so these are the screws. There, and there. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 screws. That's correct. So now we'll take those screws off. And then it's got little dowels. Okay, so that would be on your master cylinder right here. It actually pinches onto there. So it makes it quite difficult to split the casing. Just try and get all these out as quickly as possible. Sorry if the camera is wobbling. I'm using a bit of a gooseneck to hold my camera up, and it mounts to the table, so now every time I wobble the table, it wobbles the camera. It's another opportunity for me to illustrate the speed loader. Speed loader will load an additional 6 rounds in the speed loader, and all you have to do is cock your spring back and let them fall in and release that spring, and you're good to go, and you have full 12 round capacity, which is absolutely stunning. I thought it was an absolutely great idea to improve on the load capacity. Some of these little screws are very tricky to get out, so just unscrew them past the thread. This one's come out easy enough. So 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Did I say 6 or 7? Yeah, so there was one here. I don't know if I counted this one. But that's one of those ones that's a bit of a tricky one to get out of the recess. Ah, there we go. Okay. Here is also a very tricky thing now, trying to release this without damaging the casing. As you can see, I have made a couple little attempts at splitting it there. Let's try and see where I can get a good grip through there, because it is here. It is right here where it sort of wedges onto these poles, so like dowels. Also got to try and make sure you don't let anything jump up. The last thing you need are little bits and pieces of your HDP lying all over the place, not even knowing where it all goes. So a good large size screwdriver, as you can see, I have ground that down a little bit to get it more narrow to fit in there, and then I just lever it sideways just to get it to lift. But try and do it evenly all around so that it comes off. It was this pin as well, the pin that runs through here, that also is what sort of guides it. See, I give it a good wiggle without having to force too much. See, it opens quite nicely. Do like excuse the mess inside this. It is quite a messy gun. It is a customer's gun that I repaired and realized that it needs a new master cylinder. See, I don't want all this to come loose. I want to try and get it all out. There we go. So that all comes out. And that's your complete master cylinder. New master cylinder. It should be all clear. So as you guys are gonna see here, accidentally forgot the washer that goes on the master cylinder, so I'd actually had to strip it and put the washer on. Oh well, I get to add a blooper to my video. And in amongst doing that, the spring had come off the trigger sear, and I had to fight for quite a serious amount of time trying to get this thing to fit on there and stay on there. It didn't want to stay on because the part that latched onto the trigger sear had a bit of an angle to it, so it would pop off each time I try to put it on. And the new one that I took out the bank bag, you'll see in a second here, I will take out the new one, and the new one doesn't even want to fit. The new one was actually smaller than the original one, so I landed up making do with the old one, and I just angled it right and I made it fit on perfectly fine. I latched it, I tested it, it's working, so I was happy enough that that was gonna be a way forward.
What I can do is just try it and see how well it works. I left that one screw in there. Okay, just till it touches. Touches.
Right, now all the screws are back in. Now we go through systematically tightening half turns to quarter turns all the way around till the casing closes. Obviously, when you get resistance, you're going to tighten a little bit more. Check it is all closed. Good job. Just not to overdo it because you don't want to strip the threads. These are tiny little screws. Just nip them. That's it. As easy as that. Remember now, putting the gun back together, that little piece has got to be facing upright. So then we put it to the left side of the gun. Okay. This one with the little dome tip is for the bottom part here. Okay. This one that the previous guy had definitely destroyed it. There's where the grooves are. And they destroyed this. I don't know what they were trying to do, trying to get this thing out, but I had to shave some of it so that it would go out the other way. But it still works. Got it to the right size. As long as it's effective and does the job. Holds the gun together. I need that all the way in so my speed loader goes on there so I can't have any obstructions. Hit the camera. That's better. Now, yep, still sticking out just a little bit. Oh, that's much better. Now, speed loader locks on. That's it. Move everything out the way. And it's the moment of truth. Don't make that stupid mistake. Okay. Let's see. Last time I did this, the whole thing leaked out gas because the cylinder was not good. We got game. So this is ready to go. That's good news. Sorted it out. Thank you all for joining me and have a good one.
Like and subscribe to see more.
Just the fucking beginning, motherfucker.